Get in, nerds. We are playing Victoria 3. We are in the middle of trying to get Tidore to give us some land. But, you know, that doesn't mean we can't get up to any chicanery. Let me just wait until we're in the countdown to war. I don't think anyone's going to get involved in this, but it's better to be sure. And the reason I'm waiting is because I'm thinking about supporting the Dominican revolt against Cuba, so that... Ooh, we have some events. Excellent. Falling in line, the Intelligentsia, prominent supporters of the Republican Party, have proposed support for the British American Fellowship to be a component of the official party platform. We've considered the risks and are willing to push it forwards. The fact of the matter is that voters do not, and never have, cared for anything outside of our borders. Even if that climate shifts heavily against Great Britain in the coming months, we may still run an internal policy without compromising more wide-ranging principles. I see the rationale. Nevertheless, I would like to know more before committing to a side. The stance that our nation takes must not be informed by the whims of ideologues, but rather by hard necessity. The party stands together. Petite Bourgeoisie joins the British American Fellowship, or MB accused of foreign puppeteering. Interesting. I'm gonna do the second one, because I think we're rapidly reaching the time where our alliance with Great Britain has outlived its usefulness. But first, a fireside chat. Present harm in Europe has decided to use the new exciting radio technology to connect more directly with the people. It's like he's there in the room with me. It's hard not to be convinced. It should express authority, extra authority. It should make us look good, extra petite bourgeoisie approval. Petite bourgeois approval is nice, but I've got a lot of that. Let's go with authority. This will let us get up. This will let us be more flexible in wars. Speaking of which, let me just take a quick look here. So the Dominican uprising is just Puerto Rico, it looks like. So I think I'm going to side with them. And the only thing I can get is a trade agreement. Better than nothing. Alright. So, let's see. Let's go ahead and mobilize the American Expeditionary Force to deal with this. And we will grab the Atlantic Fleet and move them to the Caribbean to handle what will probably be a naval invasion. Let's take a look at what the... Yeah, I'm not worried about this skirmish infantry, trench infantry, shrapnel artillery army. Yeah, not concerned about that at all. For us comparison, Tidore is looking rock solid as well, so I'm pretty confident about that too. So we are not at war with Spain, it seems like. Even though Spain is Cuba's overlord right now, are they not? Yes, they are. Alright, interesting. The ace officer. Silas Jacobs has gained renown not merely for utilizing aircraft in battle, but even flying one himself over the skies of Western New Guinea. The papers are calling him the Red Cowboy. He's astounding. I can't tell if it'd be better to parade him around at home or keep sicking him on everyone in Western New Guinea. Your worship will help domestically. We get extra war support. That doesn't help. We're at max. Our war heroes need to stay in the war, extra offense. Ooh, that's definitely very good. Silas Jacobs, you're incredible. I wish you were in a bigger army. So yeah, we'll give him plus 30 offense permanently. That's great. Let me see, Silas Jacobs. Yeah, he's the head of the... He's one of the guys in the Army of Dixie. Let's give him some promotions. And let's see, what other diplomatic plays do we have kicking off here? Another internal European one that I cannot worry about. Same. And Lahedge... Probably not in my interests to do anything about. And what's this? This is a Greek peasant revolt where the Russians are supporting the government. So I can successfully ignore that without a problem. Alright, war with Tidore seems rock solid. And there's war with Cuba. So, that. They do not have war support protection, and they are losing, because they're fully occupied by a mixture of us and France. I think this is the partitioning of Tidore, friends. But nevertheless, let's go ahead and naval invade Cuba with the American Expeditionary Force. Alright. Oyo requests greater autonomy. No thank you. And Western New Guinea is ours. Wonderful. Did someone just embargo us? Italy. Italy, how could you? Oh, no, we're embargoing them too. Never mind, carry on. Let's go ahead and reset production methods. And what does that give us access to? A lot of oil. Interesting. So, electrics industries are still probably the thing that needs increasing the most in our market. I'm glad we finally built up enough infrastructure to produce the kind of clothes that we need. Wow, this is really even. Kind of shocking. Well, I guess we're exporting quite a bit of both, so it makes sense. Where have we got a good solid electric industry? Did we build one in Colorado? I guess we did. Let me see, what about Montana? You have some electrics industry in Montana. Let's go ahead and throw an additional 10 levels in. And we'll get that built up just as much as needed. We've got a bunch of things slated for construction, so it's going to be a while before that happens, but that'll be fine. Let's take a look at our naval invasion here. Certainly winning this naval battle by a lot. Let's go ahead and put another fleet in there just to support the main fleet. We're back down to position 2, and I'm not pleased about it. Maybe I can make a new gigantic fleet, or maybe, ooh, concrete fortifications. Excellent. So I think once we're at mobile armor, things will be easy money. Or Sangali, I don't wish to invest in you. I wish to invest in America. Got too many states with low development. Okay, 16th American Army, I told you to go. Why don't you go? Alright. We are winning this battle. And that puts us at landing progress. Come on. Come on. Oh, 63%. Oh, well, this will be really easy. That'll be fun. Hey, where's my battle screen? There we go. Yeah, I don't know why that interface keeps doing that. Things are happening. Things are happening. Oh, interesting. A religious revolt in Sokoto, and at the same time, the British are going to war against Egypt. Trying to get Hejaz. Trying to ban slavery. That's fine. I actually don't mind being drawn into that at all. But what about Sokoto? I could support the revolt, but unfortunately I can't get anything, I probably can't get anything I would want out of the situation. Only an obligation. What I really want is East Hausaland, because that would let me have the entire population of the Hausa people be Americans. Austria sides with Egypt, that's fine. Spain's begun embargoing us. Why don't you stop? Hey, Britain, what if Ooh, I could get transfer of state. Well, what state? Kandahar, Kabulistan, British Eastern New Guinea, Bougainville, Micronesia, Central Java. Central Java? Britain. I guess they are holding a bit of Java. Well, none of that's particularly useful to me. Can't get a transfer of subject. Could get another bankroll. That would be nice. What about a war goal? Nothing I really want in here. Don't want to get a bunch of infamy either. And a treaty port in Crete would not be useful to me because, having learned the hard way, that Crete often only contains one harbor, and if you take a treaty port there, that isolates it from the rest of the market. So I think we'll just sit that one out. It might be easy. Might be able to get an easy bankroll. Beautiful. Alright, now Santo Domingo is its own country. 10.5 infamy to conquer them. That'll be nice. Let's see. We have an a fascist revolt in Aceh. Is that an aristocratic revolt? Not so much. Interesting. That said, can't be bothered. I got my eye on this situation here. You know what? We will ask for a pile of cash for functionally doing nothing. And they will provide it. Excellent. Let's go ahead and send the American Expeditionary Force. Ooh. We got a front actually over here in America. That's fine. I thought this area was impassable. How are we getting here? Because this area is impassable. You know what? I don't know what's going on with that. We're going to send the American Expeditionary Force here to what I see as the main front. We'll put the Army of West Africa over here on this smaller front. We'll do the same with the Army of Central Africa. I'm just going to mobilize all the armies. Just to make sure. Let's go ahead and throw the Army of Dixie onto this main front as well. Oh my goodness, is this another communist revolt in Brazil? I think it is. Hold up. We'll see what we can get out of this situation. So France is extremely likely to align with Brazil. A census suffrage monarchy. Communist Brazil is a census suffrage council republic. Things are definitely interesting. I think I'll wait on that for now. Something going on in Germany's zone. In the germosphere. Exile from Ecuador, interesting. Rural electrification is proceeding apace. Alright, so now it looks like France is extremely unlikely to align in here. The situation is really bad with Brazil, but they are conciliatory. On the other hand, this is in the Americas, and I would... Theoretically, I would like to conquer them eventually. Maybe I'll just leave that alone. Maybe we'll just let it be. We'll just let it be right there. Alright, so force comparison here is not as good as I would like. There's war with Egypt. Force comparison here is about Midland. So let's commit a few more armies here. Let's send the Army of the Great Plains to the main front. And we'll send the Army of California to the secondary front. That should be fine. Another 50 battalions should sort the situation out. Article Hamburg. Interesting. Can't be bothered with that. Truce with Benin lasts for another 2 years. Excuse me, is there a colonizable area? There is, but I can't reach it. And then truce with Oyo lasts another 3 years. And then it's annexing time. French Republic is conciliatory. That's very interesting. You know what? Let's improve relations. Relations with Austria are still good, interestingly. Even though there's a war on. Let me see. Oh, we're moving forward in the west here. That's exciting. We've got multiple small armies over here, so that's going to be useful in terms of if we grab the Libyan desert and then we grab Libya, that'll let us split forces pretty efficiently. Meanwhile, we've got a situation in Baroda that I can't possibly be involved in. Another Hell on Earth event, this one in Mato Grosso, but the perpetrators will pay for their crimes. As you can see, we're creating hell on earth in a lot of areas. I don't know why making the perpetrators pay for their crimes doesn't seem to do anything about the issue. That just seems unrealistic. Alright, force comparisons here are looking very, very good now. Britain, I feel like you've got the wrong treaty port. Don't you want to build a canal? Britain, why don't you want to build a canal? Oh my goodness, Britain landed in Austria, but they don't seem to have an army there, so... Oh, they do have an army. If Austria can get an army over to the other side of that, though, things will be a lot easier. Beautiful. Oh, interesting. Alright, so these fronts split, so these armies are now on their way to the front they were already on. Alright, that's exciting. Little by little, this is another little by little event. We shall make Americans of them yet. Chitral, can't be bothered with that. Oh my goodness. A radical revolt in Japan. Well, that's very interesting. And it's huge. If you want peace, the armed forces suggest a more hardline approach... foreign policy towards Mexico due to poor relations. If half of what you're saying is true, I wouldn't want you anywhere near that border. But I don't think it is. Mother, you always said not to trust Mexico. Why would you trust them to respect our borders? No one wants their son to do it, but because they know it's dangerous, that's exactly why we've got to do it. Set aside polite formalities, they are the enemy. Reduces relations with Mexico, but makes the armed forces happy. Despite our mutual dislike, there's no need to escalate. Reduced authority, armed forces upset. We'll do the first one. Yeah. Action and reaction. As the news escapes Turin of yet another violent crackdown on the Italian labor movement, outraged members of the armed forces have taken to the streets of Washington, marching under the banner of the Anti-Italian Association. In the imagination of the American labor movement, Italy had long loomed as a bastion of reaction. But something felt different about this particular incident. Perhaps the violence exhibited by the Turin constabulary had been especially brutal this time. Perhaps it was just the straw that broke the camel's back. In any case, as American workers unfurled their banners and marched down towards the Ambassadorial Quarter, their cries for the overthrow of Emperor Marco Chiavas reverberated through the city as they never had before. As long as their anger is focused abroad, armed forces joins the Anti-Italian Association, or temper their rage with diplomatic action, armed forces get happier. Interesting. Well, I would definitely... Huh, that's interesting. I could take a more targeted anti-Italian policy. But what's going on here in Japan? Interesting. Japan has a defensive pact with France. Okay. So that's neat. After France tried to take them over, that's very funny. So, Japan is an autocratic theocracy. Cultural exclusion, national militia working to get onto private schools from religious schools, interventionism, protectionism, per capita taxation, tenant farmers. Radical Japan is a parliamentary autocracy and an ethnostate. Ooh. Don't love that. All right. Well, we'll see what we can get. I definitely don't want an ethnostate in Japan by any stretch of the imagination. I certainly don't think that's wise. Looks like everything's going rock solid here in our war. Does Austria have any... Oh my goodness. Okay, so none of the war goals are against Austria. So that shouldn't be a problem. So, Japan. Oh no, this is the revolt. I don't want that. All I can get is an obligation. But an obligation is just fine. Alright, we'll go ahead and send the Army of the Andes to cover the far southern front. We'll send the Army of the Isthmus to cover the main front. And we'll go ahead and send the Army of West Africa to cover the secondary southern front. I don't think we're actually going to need all of these armies over here in the war in Egypt. Particularly because this war is going just fantastically. Britain's already naval invading Hejaz over here, so that shouldn't be a problem. In fact, let's go ahead and get the Army of California over here to Japan on the northern front. Now, if nobody else gets involved in this, I think we'll probably just let the situation be. What army is this? Why does this army keep popping up? Romanian mass immigration, excellent. And let's go ahead and pull the Army of the Great Plains over to what I see is again as the main front in Japan. Because that's going to be a medium-sized war, but this war is basically done right now. Italy sides with Ecuador, but over what? Ah, a religious revolt. Sad. I don't think I necessarily want to take this simply as an opportunity to fight the Italians. What are they getting out of it? Oh, they're allied. Well, that's fine. Alright, situation Hawaii, not my business. Revolt in the Nejid, not my business. Arautoa doesn't involve me. Communist Netherlands. Well, that's interesting. I have a truce with the Netherlands, but low relations, so I can't actually get involved. So it is what it is. And a Schleswigian revolt as well. Let's see. How are our armies doing? Atlantic Fleet is not doing great. Need another leader in here. Let's see. Well, you're the only one who's not reckless. You're in it. American troops are in Japan. In fact, more and more are arriving every day. Austria's bailed out of this war, which means it's going to be done very, very soon. Actually, we've almost got Egypt fully occupied. Well, now we've got Egypt fully occupied, I think. Is there another front somewhere? They should surrender as soon as they're fully occupied. Anyway, not my business. I've already contributed to the war significantly. And there's the war with Radical Japan kicking off. All of my troops are where they need to be. And the rest of my armies are on the way to basically arbitrary locations. American Expeditionary Force, let's get you onto this front, which I see is kind of the main one. Army of Central Africa, we can have you go to... You're already on the way to the Ryukyus. And the Army of Dixie, here to the southern front. Yeah, I think as long as we can continue to hold in these secondary fronts, I don't think there's going to be a problem. Army of West Africa is really low on morale. Well, that's fine. They're in the middle of a fight, so that makes sense. Radical Japan does seem to have a gigantic force, but... Austria stopped damaging relations. That's excellent. So this is, again, what I see as the main front. The battle for Nagoya, the battle for Chubu. So if we can continue to push north from here, then a lot of these other fronts are kind of not much of a factor. We are losing over here, but we're inflicting tons and tons of casualties. That's interesting. I'm actually surprised that Japan's rebel army is able to put this much force together. Wow, there sure are a lot of armies. I just got an achievement and I completely missed it. I'll have to check the footage later. Alright, Force of Mirrors in here is doing a lot better. So that's good. We've advanced forward in Chubu and taken it. So now we're moving to attack Kanto and Tohoku. Once we've got Tohoku and Hokkaido, that'll sort that situation out. And if we can get a hold of Kyushu. I always confuse Kyushu and Shikoku. Oh my goodness. A Qing explosion. In 1923. How could this happen? Oh my goodness. Huh. Well, look at this. This certainly does offer some opportunities, doesn't it? So, what's this war? This war is between the Heavenly Kingdom and the Beiyang government. The Xinjiang clique has taken the northwest. Shibei has taken a lot of the center of the north. The Shanxi clique has taken this region here in Shanxi, Xi'an, Henan, and Western Hubei. We got the Beiyang government just in Beijing. There's a Shandong clique that controls Shandong, northern Anhui, Jiangsu, Nanjing, and Suzhou. We've got a Zhili clique holding just Hebei. We've got an Anhui clique holding southern Anhui, eastern Hubei, Zhejiang, and Jiangxi. And then finally we've got the Heavenly Kingdom holding this whole swath of the south, and we've got a Yunnan clique holding Yunnan. Interesting. Oh, and the Beiyang government also holds Formosa. Is this technically called Formosa in this? Yeah, it is. Taiwan. Alright. So, the Heavenly Kingdom is... So normally when I play a traditionalist power, I help the Heavenly Kingdom. But I'm not playing that right now. This has just created a lot of options for us. Joseon is also independent, it seems. Let's start by declaring some interests over here. Maybe we'll have some opportunities for getting up to chicanery later. Great Britain. Our alliance has proven very useful, but it is at an end. So they're now cautious. I am going to improve relations. Nope, they've downgraded to wary. Well, that's fine. Alright, we are definitely winning against Radical Japan now. Obviously, a lot of these fronts have been somewhat inconclusive. But, again, the main front, very conclusive. Alright, here we go. Now since we've got Hokkaido, things will be easier. So, what would it take to turn Joseon into a protectorate? 22.7 infamy. I'd love to do that. Yeah, I think long term, now that we've had a Qing explosion, imperialism in China is definitely going to be on the way. Let's also... Can we guarantee the Raj? They don't want our guarantee. Well, that's interesting. Let's improve relations. Oh, relations are bad. That's what's going on. Okay, we'll improve relations with them, because knocking out the Raj is the primary path to weakening Britain. Alright, beautiful. That solved the issue in Japan. I hope you're pleased. Serving mass migration. Excellent. So now we're going to get an investment agreement. And I think at this point, once relations with Britain are... Oh, relations with Britain are amicable again. Excellent. So I need to improve relations with France. Austria wants a trade agreement. Absolutely. That is just fine with me. And this is a situation in Bunyoro. Obviously, Oyo is still defiant. And I don't have the influence to improve relations with them, which is a shame. But I'm doing a lot of stuff here. This... I actually can get involved in this. So let's see. The Bunyoro Proletarian Revolt. You know what? Sure. Thank you. Movement for Migration Controls is pretty strong, but I genuinely don't need it. I am at over half loyalists at this point. This is incredible. And there's mobile armor. Excellent. So, let's go ahead and start out. Right. Let's go ahead and start out by grabbing our war machine industries and setting them all to producing tanks. And now, we'll upgrade all of our infantry. Heavy tanks and light tanks need to be produced separately, but for infantry, you can get that started right away. So we'll see what that does to the market. Where is tanks? Tanks are very cheap right now, but the barracks are still converting. There's going to be demand for tanks any minute now. There we go. Perfect. There's nitrogen fixation. I basically never switched to nitrogen fixation. I think I almost completely just totally overruns my farms to the point where they're completely unproductive. Unregulated automobiles. Great. Due to a spate of accidents, there have been calls to regulate automobiles. It's being reported that an out-of-control automobile crashed into a wall at high speeds, killing the driver. Faster than a horse and twice as heavy. If people don't see why that's dangerous, I don't know what to tell you. Stricter laws make for safer streets, reduce motor industry's throughput, industrialists mad. People merely need to adjust, industrialists happy. Our automobiles should have the right of way. 5% of lower sternum pops become radical. I don't know. I'm going to say people just need to adjust. That seems like all benefits. I wonder if that reduces the health of all characters above a certain class. That would be fun. That'd be an exciting and interesting outcome for this. Alright, so there's the Bunyaro affair closed out, and we are actually way over time for this episode. So, that is all for today. I've had fun. I hope you've had fun, and I'll see you on the other side.